reaction is second order with respect to a reactant. How is the rate of reaction affected? The concentration of the reactant is doubled and reduced to half. Okay, see, now the problem is let the concentration of the reactant of A is equal to what? A. So the rate of reaction will be rate is equal to K into concentration of A power 2 because of the second order reaction. That's why the power 2. Then here concentration of A is equal to A, so that A rate is R is equal to K into A square. The question is what? The reaction is doubled. The reactant is doubled means. So A concentration of A is equal to 2A because this is 1, so doubled means 2A. So R dash is equal to K into 2A power 2. Because of this reaction, you have to put this value in this reaction so that you will get 4KA square. So KA square is what? R. So that 4R. This means the rate of the reaction here, that's mean the concentration of the reactant is doubled, so that the rate of the reaction would increase by 4 times. Okay. The next is reduced to half. So reduced to half, concentration of A is equal to half into A. So R doubled as, that is K into 1 by 2 power A, 1 by 2 A power 2. So this will become 1 by 4 into KA square. Then you will get the K is what? KA square is R, so that 1 by 4 R. Here the decreases, the rate of the reaction decreases 1 by 4 time. The rate constant for a first order reaction is 60 second. That is 60 second inverse. How much time will take to reduce the initial concentration of the reactant towards 1 by 16th value? So here the rate constant is what? The rate constant for a first order reaction 60. So that K is equal to 60 second inverse, and that R is 1 by 16th value, so that the R naught will be 1. So formula is, for the first order reaction formula is, K is equal to 2.303 divided by T into log of R naught divided by R. So we have to find T. The K value is given here, so that rearrange the formula, T is equal to 2.303 divided by K into log of R naught by R. Then 2.303, substitute the K value, 60 second inverse, and log of R naught is 1, then R is 1 by 16. Then after simplifying, you get 2.303 divided by 60 second inverse into log 16. So rearrange this, you will get the log 16. Then taking of log value for this and simplifying this, you will get T is equal to 4.6 into 10 power minus 2 second. That is, the time required time is T is equal to 4.6 into 10 power minus 2 seconds. For a first order reaction, so that time required for 99% completion is twice the time required for the completion of 90% of the reaction. So here the first order reaction for 99% completion, that will be the initial concentration R is equal to 100 because of the percentage. R will be 99%, so that 100 minus 99. So the formula is T is equal to 2.303 divided by K into log of R naught by R. So this is T1, and because of we have to find out two times, that is why T1. So T1 is equal to 2.303 divided by K into log of R naught by R. So 2.303 divided by K into log R naught is what? 100. Then R is 100 minus 99. So it will become 1. So log 100. So 2.303 divided by K into log 100. Log 100 means what? That is, log 100 will be 2. So the value of log 100 is 2. So that 2.303 divided by K into 2. Then second is what? 99, the required for the completion of 90% of the reaction. So 90% of completion is R naught, here also 100. R is equal to 100 minus 90. In the first case 99, the second case is 90. So T2 is equal to 2.303 divided by K into log of 100 divided by 100 minus 90. So it will become 10. So 2.303 divided by K into log of 100 divided by 10, it's become log 10. So log 10 value is what? 1. So 2.303 divided by K into 1. So T2 is equal to what? 2.303 divided by K. T1 is equal to what? 2.303 by K into 2. So that, therefore, the T1 is equal to 2 T2. That's mean the time required for 99 completion of a first order reaction is twice the time required for the completion of 90% of the reaction. But this numerical, student, for the reaction, reactant gives product, the concentration of a reactant changes from 0.03 molar to 0.02 molar in 25 minutes. Calculate average rate of reaction using units of time both in minutes and seconds. Okay, now here the first is what? The average rate of the reaction is minus delta R divided by delta T. Already we know that. Here the two different concentrations are we are using, that's why minus the reactant side, so that R2 minus R1 divided by the time is T2 minus T1. Here the R2 is what? R2 is 0.02 molar and that R1 is 0.03 molar divided by minute, the time, the variation of time is what? That is 25 minutes. So 25 minutes, then unit is concentration for molar and the minute for this time. Then after simplifying, you will get 0.01 divided by 25 molar minute inverse. Then after simplifying, taking a log of both values, then you will get 4 into 10 power minus 4 molar minute inverse. For seconds is, take this value, second is per minute 60, so that 60, then you will get 6.67 into 10 power minus 6 molar second inverse. A first order reaction has a rate constant as 1.15 into 10 power minus 3 second inverse. How long will 5 gram of this reactant take to reduce 3 gram? So here the initial concentration is what? Here there is the initial R0. So R0 is 5 and the R is reduced to 2, that is the final, so that 3. Then the rate constant is given here, that is 1.15 into 10 power minus 3 second inverse. So the first order reaction formula is K is equal to 2.303 divided by T into log of R0 by R. Here we have to find out the time. So rearrange the formula. T is equal to 2.303 divided by K into log of R0 by R. So here the 2.303, K is what here? The K is 1.15 into 10 power minus 3. So R0 is what? 5. So 5, log of 5 divided by 3. Then after simplifying this, 2.303 divided by this, this log 5 by 3 will become log 5 minus log 3. So take the log values and you will get this value. After getting that log value, you will get the 0.02219. Then simplify this values, you will get 444.38 seconds, approximately 444 seconds. Look at this numerical. Time required to decompose SO2Cl2 to half of its initial amount is 60 minutes. If the decomposition is a first order reaction, calculate the rate constant of the reaction. So for the first order reaction, we know that for half-life formula is T half is equal to 0.693 divided by K. We know that the T half is given, there is 60 minutes. So T half is 60, 0.63 divided by 693 divided by K. So we have to find out the K. So K is what here? K is equal to 0.693 divided by 60 minute. So then after we will get that value is 0.0115 minute inverse, or you can write it that is 1.155 into 10 power minus 2 minute inverse. Okay, that K value will be what? That is K is equal to 1.925 into 10 power minus 4 second inverse.